hell have you done?
Scarlet, please, sit down.
Sit down? Do you think taking my children's going to stop me?
Stop you from doing what exactly?
Where did you take them?
This is far more important right now.
More important
than... We need stability. The country needs stability, and this act provides that. Work with me.
This country needs its freedom. Michael wouldn't have agreed to this. He's the one that started this act, and he did it...
Michael is dead. This country is a far different place than it was 3 years ago, Scarlet. There's rioting in the streets, for God's sake. We need tighter security now more than ever. People on our doorstep want to hurt us. I can't allow that.
That's not your decision to make. The people need to know that their government is lying to them. And you can't threaten me into silence on this.
You can't see this right now, but you don't have another choice here.
Charles?
Open the file.
Either way, I suppose. But I did what I thought was right at the time. That's all anyone can do, isn't it? Mullen was terrible at remembering to lock windows. I wonder if he ever realized his role in all of this. Keycards were beginning to restrict everyone's access. Having the correct level of security clearance was important.
Steve, the fuse box for Charles Bowman's office is playing up.
Steve and Dan were on patrol that evening. Both good men.
What, again?
Don't worry, maintenance are going to be on it first thing in the morning. If it trips again, just leave it. No need us running up and down the stairs every 10 minutes for a false alarm.
If they caught me up there, they wouldn't believe what I was doing.
Okay, roger that. Makes my life easier anyway.
That's not me telling you to take a break. You still have a job to do.
But I had no intention of being caught.
Yeah, of course. No problem. I'll be in the lobby if you need that.
People were still researching union law. Too little, too late. The guard patrol was quite loose at the facility, at least before for all of this. They wouldn't be back anytime soon. The books belonged to the library and weren't allowed to be checked out. I always found it odd that the books we read were so highly monitored. Everything I needed was on that cartridge. The fate of a nation in ones and zeros. He would have understood. Sometimes I wonder if I'm just telling myself that, but he would have understood. The Silhouette server housed hundreds of files on the Union Act, immigrant families, voting preferences, you name it. I missed a phone call from Michael that night.
1, new message. Message 1.
Hey, Hallie. We must have just missed each other's calls. Not to worry. Look, I'm heading across to the Meta Center. Apparently, there's something to do with one of the servers malfunctioning. I'm sure it's nothing too serious. Anyway, I'll try and call again soon. Okay. Love you. Bye.
End of messages. End of messages. Message 2. End of messages. End of messages.
Very moment. Our lives changed forever.
Steve, I've had a security alert. I've paged you the location.
I didn't want security to see me up there. They were already on edge from the server blowing. I made my way downstairs. Fire exit was the only route out. That green glow was my only focus now. Once I was out, there was no way back in. The events that transpired next were out of my control.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, Mrs. Carson, it's you. I didn't expect you to still be here. I'm going to have to report you in the system. I'm sure you understand. Shouldn't you be leaving, Mrs. Carson?
The air smelt thick with something burning that night. Protesters were getting worse, even before what happened. As I walked further from the facility, I almost forgot how bad things were. Was always so peaceful. I remember someone listening to music on a canal boat. Funny, it wouldn't be safe to be out there now. The walk home usually helped me clear my mind after a day's work. That night was different. I was thinking about Michael. He'd be sat at home waiting for me. That had so much to talk about. The pre-union act was tearing the city apart. It wouldn't be long before the whole country was rioting. At the time, I didn't feel like I could make a change. I didn't have a voice.
Hey, all right, how are you doing?
I best get up. Speak to you later.
The only way to stop the act from happening was to do something more radical, something, you know. I often wonder what he would have thought of me. More than you can ever know.
concern token.
It wasn't supposed to be. I didn't know. If I knew, I was going to lose Michael. I'm so sorry, Michael. I just didn't know. That's why we're doing this.
Not a great deal can be said in favor of the past two governments' policies when referring to the UK's outlook on foreign relations. For a second time, the public opinion poll has shown dissatisfaction and, dare I say it, contempt for the way that the PM has handled the country's affairs of late. More money going out. I've said this 100 times, I'm sure, but... So sorry for your loss. A toast to the man and the memory. I imagine you'll need to take some personal time. That's fine. Just take what you need. I'll handle everything on my end. I know you and I see differently on a few things, but this is a time for solidarity, not turmoil. Well, perhaps with all that's happened, we can finally work together. Deal with things head on. Nobody could have seen this coming, Scarlet. You mustn't blame yourself.
Harvey Miller, do you ever answer your phone? I've finished editing the introduction to the Bowman Carson piece you sent me. It's good, but I think we can do better. Alex Dubois has claimed that he wasn't at the facility the time that they say he set off the explosion. He also says the phone records from the night prove it. Apparently, Detective Holden has them. Anyway, your first meeting is tomorrow. Find out everything you can. The phone records are a good start, but I have a feeling there's a bigger story here. Anyway, get some sleep and I'll be in touch tomorrow. Harvey, your first meeting is with Carla Berman. Get there an hour early so you have time to look around and gather questions for your meeting. Follow any leads you can for the Miller report. Good luck and don't trust anyone.
Hello, Clarice. I'll eat your liver.
Hey, man. I'm just a girl standing in front of a guy asking for a love thing.
I am your father.
No! Mr. Miller, is it? We weren't expecting you for another 20 minutes. Not a problem at all. Welcome to Bowman Carson. My name's Steve Crow. Apologies for the protesting outside. I hope it wasn't too hard to get through them. If you don't mind, can you place your briefcase down on the conveyor belt there so I can check it for you? Okay, great. I just need to check through it. Sorry about this. Seems to be in order. Here's your ID badge. If you could just follow me to the security desk.
Did you... Great. Oh, there's no other land for me. Damn it, he's got that song stuck in my head.
Ah, Mr. Miller. We didn't expect you so early. Let me just print your agenda. Give me a second. Your first is... speak of the devil. Carla. This is Mr. Miller from the Turing Post. You have a meeting today, I believe.
Yes, of course. A pleasure to meet you, Mr. Miller. Is it that time already?
No. Mr. Miller is just fashionably early.
Oh, good. For a moment, I thought I was running behind. I'll be ready in my office for our meeting as scheduled. I have to run, I'm afraid, but we'll speak soon. Thank you, Dan.
Righty-o, Carla. Right, here's your agenda. Great.
Why don't you read that over and put it in your briefcase for safekeeping? I suppose that's everything from me. If you need anything further, you know where I am.
Everything dated the 10th of the 4th, 1987, the day of the attack, has been boxed and archived and still needs reviewing. The phone records were particularly interesting to me. I've looked through about 20% of all the files I've collated as of yet, and I'm not sure exactly how much more I'm going to find. I'm certain I'm onto something big, but I fear it's going to take me a lot longer than I have to find what I need.
Hey, Mr. Miller.
Been an alarm set off. Can you go check it out?
Thank you.
just getting a drink of water. Can you cover me?
Carla, 10 days. 10 bloody days. How the hell could you have kept this from me? I swear to God, my family are going to be deported because of you, and I could have done something about it. Why the hell didn't you tell me? Why the hell didn't you tell me? This is your fault. Everything that happens next is your fault.
Listen, Mr. Miller, I know this probably has nothing to do with you, but there was an alarm that went off earlier on, so if you could just make sure to stay in the allocated areas, that would be great. Mr. Miller, don't forget about that meeting with Carla.
You can find something to do in the meantime.